Hello friends, myself Deepak and welcome to my channel Deepak Biology Classes. So friend, today we are going to discuss about the three kingdom classification. So before going to that, let me remind you about my last lecture. So in the last lecture, we have studied about the two kingdom system which was given by Carolus Linnaeus. So according to him, he has classified the two kingdom system into Plantae and Animalia. So what was the criteria and on the basis of what criteria he has divided into Plantae and the Animalia? So he has used two most important criteria. The first one is on the basis of cell wall, okay, and the second one is on the basis of photosynthetic capability. So these were the two important criteria. On the basis of that, Carolus Linnaeus, he divided the whole organisms which are present on the earth into two kingdoms, that is Plantae and Animalia. So student, today we will talk about the three kingdom classification. So this classification, it has given by Ernst Haeckel. It is given by Ernst Haeckel. Okay, in 1866. So, like Linnaeus, he divided into two kingdoms, Plantae and Animalia. So, there was some drawbacks was there because of that. That two kingdom classification system has been failed. So, what Haeckel did, he has introduced one more kingdom, okay, and the name of that kingdom is Protista, in order to overcome the drawbacks which was in the Carolus Linnaeus two kingdom system. So what he did, he divided into this is Plantae and this is one is Animalia. Okay, like that, what Linnaeus did, he also divided into two kingdom, Plantae and Animalia, but there was no place for unicellular organism. Okay, so what this Ernst Haeckel did, he has introduced one more kingdom or group which is called Protista. Okay, he has introduced one more group which is called Protista. Okay, so what was the criteria and on the basis of what he has divided in, he has created one more group, that is Protista. So the criteria was, he has placed all those organisms which lack tissue differentiation. Okay, so this was the main point, and on the basis of this criteria, Ernst Haeckel has introduced one more group, that is called the Protista, and he has kept all those organisms which lack the tissue differentiation. Okay, like for example, if we take the example, then bacteria. Okay, then protozoans and all and he has then introduced fungi also in this group. Okay, fungi also. Okay, so what is mean by this tissue differentiation? Normally these bacteria, protozoa, they don't have the capability to differentiate tissue. Okay, if we compare this with us, like a humans. So in humans, what happened, that after the formation of tissue, then tissue formed organs, and then organs form organ system, and then the whole organism is formed. But that type of tissue differentiation is not seen in case of bacteria, protozoa. Okay, so this was the important criteria, and on the basis of that, he had introduced one more group of kingdom, Protista, and he kept all the organisms which lack tissue differentiation, for example bacteria, protozoa and fungi. But later on, what happened, these fungi and some multicellular algae, they have been taken out from the group. Okay, so now we will see the drawbacks or the limitations or the objections because of that this three kingdom system has also been failed. So what are those drawbacks? Let me see. So, objections, or we can say limitations, or drawbacks. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the drawbacks, limitations, or the objection. Because of that, this system has also been failed. So what is the drawback? So first drawback is no separation of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So what he did, in the same group Protista, he has classified all the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes. He didn't tell about anything about the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So he placed, what he did, he has introduced all the prokaryotes and the eukaryotes in the same group, that is Protista. So the first drawback is that. Now we'll talk about the second one. Second one is what? Both unicellular and multicellular. Organism has been placed. Okay, so the second drawback, what was the second drawback? The second drawback is both unicellular and multicellular organism has been placed under the group Protista. So he didn't differentiate about the unicellular organism and the multicellular organism. So all the organisms who are unicellular and multicellular, he has kept in the group Protista. Now we'll see third one. Photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic. Organism under Protista. So in the same kingdom Protista, he has kept all the photosynthetic organisms as well as non-photosynthetic organisms. Means those organisms which have the capacity to produce their own food, he has kept in the Protista group, and other group which don't have the capacity to produce the food with the help of photosynthesis, that organism has also been placed in the same group under Protista. Okay. Autotrophic and non-autotrophic, or we can say heterotrophic. So as I discussed, autotrophic means all the plants, means like some algae like the chlamydomonas, and some prokaryotes like the cyanobacteria, they have the capacity to produce their own food. So they have kept in the autotrophic and non-autotrophic. If we talk about the bacteria which are dependent on some other organisms for their food, along with that we can say the example of fungi also, that fungi are dependent on some other organism for their food. So he has classified all those organisms, autotrophic and the heterotrophic, in the same group. Okay, next, fifth. So walled and wall-less in the same group. Okay. Last point was is walled and wall-less in the same group. Means he has classified all the organisms which is having the cell wall, and those organisms which don't have cell wall, he has placed in the same group. So walled, for example, bacteria, they are having cell wall which is made up of peptidoglycan, and the wall-less, for example, mycoplasma. So these mycoplasma, they don't have cell wall. So what this Haeckel did, he has placed all the walled organism and the non-walled, like wall-less, like a mycoplasma, they have kept in the same group under Protista. So these are some drawbacks of the three kingdom system. Because of that, this three kingdom system, which was given by the Haeckel, has been failed. So friends, the first one is no separation of prokaryotes and eukaryotes, means they have kept prokaryotes and eukaryotes under the same Protista group. Second one, both unicellular and multicellular organisms have been placed, means the organism which is having single cell or which is having more than one cell has been placed under the same group. Third, photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic organisms has been placed under the Protista. Fourth, autotrophic and non-autotrophic have been placed in the same group. And the last one is walled and wall-less organisms have been also placed in the same group. Okay, so this is a three kingdom system. That and there are some limitations or the objections or drawbacks. Because of these drawbacks, this three kingdom classification has been failed. So after that, what happened? To overcome this three kingdom classification, a new kingdom came, or we can say a new kingdom classification came, which is four. Okay, which is four kingdom classification. That four kingdom classification I will discuss in my next class. Okay, so we will meet now in the next class. So if you like this video, then please subscribe my channel. If you are okay, so the next four kingdom classification we will study in my next lecture. Okay, thank you, dhanyavad.